So, over the past few months, we have seen many new Apple products. New iPads, new iPhones, new MacBook Airs, and even a refreshed 13-inch MacBook Pro, all of which have had amazing refreshes. But I'm holding out for the updates for the bigger Pro laptops. Here's why. This is the M2 MacBook Pro. Let's talk about it. The new M2 MacBook Pro will be Apple's flagship laptop with killer performance and hopefully the same price as last year. So far, there isn't too much information on the pricing of this laptop. At least in the US, if there isn't a redesign, it'll probably be somewhat similar. But for other markets, that's TBD. Moving on, for form factors, the laptop will have two sizes, with both amazing displays. With either 14 or 16-inch screens with mini LED, 120Hz refresh rates, and the now famous Apple notches. Personally, I'm not a big fan of the notches, but they do allow for more screen real estate. And they're pretty subtle, so don't worry about them causing too many issues. And keeping in mind that allegedly all of the features for the display will be the same as last year, they could reduce the size of the notch a little. But that's all the form factor information we've got thus far. Now let's talk about its amazing connectivity. Last year, Apple surprised everyone with its amazing port selection with the new MacBook Pro laptops. And allegedly, that's continuing, which is amazing. It covers nearly everyone's needs. But maybe an extra USB port would be nice too. But gosh, nice job, Apple. And for cameras, you won't be disappointed. 1080p resolution, which is not the greatest, but it surely is good. Good enough for a laptop, I'd say. But also, you could use the continuity cam feature, which uses your iPhone as a camera for your laptop, which will be even higher quality, so good stuff. But here's where the real meat and potatoes come from, the internal specs. With M2, I expect there to certainly be a jump in performance, but we'll see. It will probably be a relatively incremental upgrade performance-wise, but it will definitely not disappoint. For reference, here's the difference in performance between the old M1 chips found in the MacBook Airs and the M1 Pro and M1 Max found in the current MacBook Pros. And on top of that, here's the M2 chip. There's a pretty significant performance difference between M1 and M2, so extrapolating that to the presumed M2 Pro and M2 Max, this is likely what we'll see. So alright, not bad, not bad at all. But my one complaint that I genuinely have with these laptops would be the storage situation. Apple is just incredibly stingy with the storage of its devices because, well, it can. It's one of the few ways that many consumers will spec up their devices, meaning more money to be spent. So it makes sense why these things start low, but 512GB for the starter model, that's very low all things considered. For $2,000 starting, that's about $4 per gigabyte with this device, so pretty expensive. Bare minimum, I think it'd be better if it starts with 1TB. But Apple's a business, and businesses need to make money, so alright. It'd be nice to have more storage, but don't get your hopes up. Now for batteries, last year, both devices had incredible battery lives, lasting all day for most people, unless they had intense workloads, which is incredible. And thankfully, we're expected to see the same thing, with hopefully a little bump in how long each lasts, if we're being optimistic. So great, well-rounded devices. Now lastly, for the operating system, the laptop runs macOS, which, according to the rumors, is why we won't be seeing this laptop until spring, or more specifically, March-ish of next year. Apparently, Apple was considering announcing this laptop in November, but given all the buzz of the new iPhones and iPads, decided to hold off until later, to around the time when the new macOS update Ventura releases. Which actually would make a lot of sense, because that's what the company did for the new iPads. And with that release, we expect to see a new Mac Mini and Mac Pro too. So they'll all be coming soon, we just gotta be patient. Let's get on to my verdict. So are the new MacBook Pros worth it? Well, let me set this straight, for most people, no. Probably not. They're really expensive for non-professionals, and for many people, they might provide too much power that you won't ever use. Does this mean that the laptop is too expensive? For some people, probably. But for professionals, it's pretty reasonable. In fact, for its price, it seems to be pretty amazing for its target market, just like its predecessor, the market literally being in the laptop's name. Pros. Even still, many students buy the MacBook Pros, which they probably don't need, but they still provide a ton of performance and most definitely won't disappoint. But overall, yeah, I'd say that these laptops are better for creatives than for students. If you're a photo or video editor, modeler, animator, anything like that, you'll most definitely love this laptop. It's powerful, portable, and connectable with that amazing port selection. For my typical students though, who don't run too intensive programs, I would just recommend getting the M2 MacBook Air or even the M1 version. Those will provide more than enough performance for the majority of you. Unless you're an engineering student or something of the sort, then you should probably get a Windows laptop. but for professionals and creatives, definitely check out this laptop when it arrives. Are they worth the wait? If you can, most definitely. But at the end of the day, these laptops are just tools. They're fun to talk about, but they're made for productivity. So if you need one right now, you could just get the M1 MacBook Pros when they're on sale, and they won't disappoint. But if you can wait, I'm sure the new M2 MacBook Pro will be a great laptop. So overall, the new M2 MacBook Pros, presumed to be released early 2023, are very exciting with many great new features and very few compromises. My name is Cyrus. It's spelled like Cyrus, pronounced like Seerooster. Just take out the tur. Thank you very much for watching and have a wonderful day. Peace.